Cathedral. And with much pride and joy, I would like to welcome you to the celebration of the 50th anniversary of the dedication of the cathedral. We are very grateful indeed for all the blessings that God has bestowed on this hallowed ground, the faith of the people, the living stones that have made this house of God withstand the vicissitudes of time and events. We are also very grateful for the love that has united us together as we march together to our heavenly home. As we sing and pray together tonight, let this be a testament to our commitment to love the cathedral into the coming years. And I would like to welcome all the different groups and all the different people that are here. The Equestrian Order of the Holy Sepulchre of Jerusalem, the Sovereign Military Order of Malta, the Arch-Confraternity of the Knights of St. Francis, the Legion of Mary, Knights of Columbus, both the Cathedral Council and the Regional Council membership, the Cruzada Guadalupana de San Francisco, and all the other Latinos that are here, the Cathedral Holy Name Society, the Cathedral St. Vincent de Paul Society, Missionaries of Charity, members of the Cathedral Parish Council, and all the other parishioners that are here. We also welcome, of course, the Filipinos and the other Asians who are present with us to celebrate tonight. So for a while, I've been searching for a heaven-sent choir. I finally found it in the cathedral. So now, let us listen to the cathedral choir.
Thank you. O God, come to my assistance.
Lord, make haste to help me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia. We praise the Mother of our Church, the pure and spotless one. In poverty she carried Christ, she walked with him through death and life. Now wears the heavenly crown. Now wears the heavenly crown. She is the captain of the saints. She leads in humbleness. Let our community take heart and humbly, justly do our part to teach, to pray, to bless, to teach, to pray, to bless. Just as our Mother leads this church, our founders built this home. Let us continue laying stones of faith and hope and love alone for those who are to come, for those who are to come. Oh, may the Holy Trinity forever be adored. Praise God the Father, God the Son, and God the Spirit, three in one, and worship evermore, and worship evermore.
A reading from Revelation. I saw New Jerusalem, the holy city, coming down out of heaven from God, beautiful as a bride, prepared to meet her husband. I heard a loud voice from the throne cry out, "This is God's dwelling among men. He shall dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and he shall be their God, who is always with them." I saw no temple in the city. The Lord God, the Almighty, is the temple, he and the Lamb. But nothing profane shall enter it, nor anyone who is a liar or has done a detestable act. Only those shall enter whose names are inscribed in the book of the living, kept by the Lamb.
It is certainly my pleasure to welcome you here today to our cathedral to begin this year of observance of the Jubilee year, the Golden Jubilee of our cathedral. Of course, the original plan is that this would be the conclusion of a year of celebration, as it was exactly 50 years ago this day that Archbishop Joseph McGuckin dedicated this magnificent cathedral to Our Lady under her title of St. Mary of the Assumption. Obviously, we had to delay that for a year, but we are certainly grateful to be able to return to our churches and celebrate in these holy houses of God. Our cathedral truly is distinctive in the history of the church, especially in our own time, built when it was in dedicated in 1971, rising as a phoenix from the ashes of the previous cathedral that had burned down 9 years before. If I'm not mistaken, St. Mary's is the first church that was built specifically to be a cathedral after the Second Vatican Council. Some of you might go home and do some Googling and find out, no, there is another one some other part of the world, but if there was, it's certainly one of the very first, and certainly the most daring. It's a brilliant design that incorporates the vision of the council in a way that retains the classical elements of church architecture and reinterprets them in a way to speak to our own age, but also with timeless beauty. It's especially notable because, if I may be so frank, it was built at the beginning of a time that was, let's say, not exactly exemplary for the building of new churches. We understand in our Catholic vision that a church building is more than just functional. It's more than just a place to conduct a worship service being protected from the elements. We have a sacramental vision, the physical world, physical, tangible reality mediates what is spiritual, what is transcendent beyond it. So our churches have this certain symbolic, even sacramental character, where a door isn't just a passageway to be closed, to protect from the elements and open for people to enter and leave, but they symbolize Christ, who is the door, for example, the dome to represent heaven. Our cathedral then was built at this time when it was an era when functionality prevailed over art, where practicality prevailed over that sacramental sense. The council certainly urged the church to be engaged with the world, to especially the lay faithful in their vocation to bring the seeds of the gospel and plant them in their spheres of influence, in the marketplace, as the theologians say, out in the world, rubbing shoulders with those most need to hear the good news. So our cathedral is built with clear glass windows that see out onto the city, onto the world in which we are to be engaged, where, while we are here in God's house that represents the community of heaven. And yet it also incorporates the vertical dimension. Our cathedral masterfully incorporates both dimensions. The horizontal, we are people sent forth into the world to fulfill the Great Commission. And the vertical, we are people set apart as the people of God, called to the high life of heaven. And even in the glorious dome itself, in the design of the stained glass windows, depicting the four elements, classical elements of the ancient world, of earth, air, water, and fire. So all of creation is assumed up into heaven. As Our Lady, to whom this glorious church is dedicated, was assumed body and soul into heaven to share her Son's glory. She is the model of the church for us. She is virgin and mother. Our church, despite the flaws of her members, continues to hand on the pure doctrine of Christ, continues to be the conduit by which he bestows upon us the saving grace of the sacramental life of the church. The church is pure in this sense, and the church is also our mother. As she conceived by the Holy Spirit the Son of God in her womb and brought him into the world, so the church, as our mother, receives his true teaching, the beauty of his truth, receives his grace to then give birth to new citizens for God's kingdom through baptism, nourishing that life as a mother nourishes her children with the other sacraments, and teaching them the pure doctrine of Christ. The church leads us down this path of truth, beauty, and goodness, teaching the truth of Christ, guiding us in the way to live in holiness of life and righteousness, that we might know the true happiness that God wants of us, and we might be wise to avoid the deceptions of the evil one who so easily trips us up with his false promises. We thank God for all those who dedicated so much to the building of this glorious cathedral that maintains, again, the timeless qualities of church architecture with the beauty of the art, with the sense of transcendence, and incorporating the vision of the Second Vatican Council of a greater thrust to go out into the world with the universal call to holiness as is depicted on the window above the entrance to the church. Let us pray that Our Lady might be this model for us and intercede for us. Let us dedicate this year of Jubilee to her, that as she now shares the glory of her Son, the first in the order of heaven to share in his glory, so we too might give our own fiat, our own yes, to God's call in our own life, that we might share her Son's glory with him when we make our final passage from this life to the next. our Savior laid down his life so that all God's scattered children might be gathered together. In our need, let us cry out. Remember your church, Lord.
Lord Jesus, you built your house upon rock. Strengthen your church with solid and lasting faith.
Remember your church, Lord.
Lord Jesus, blood and water flowed from your side. Give new life to your church through the sacraments of your new and unending covenant.
Remember your church, Lord.
Lord Jesus, you are in the midst of those who gather in your name. Hear the prayers of your universal church.
Remember your church, Lord.
Lord Jesus, you prepare a dwelling place in your Father's house for all who love you. Help your church to grow in divine love.
Remember your church, Lord.
Lord Jesus, you never cast out anyone who comes to you. Open your Father's house to all who have died.
Remember your church, Lord. God has shown us his love. With praise and thanksgiving, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Father, each year we recall the dedication of this church to your service. Let our worship always be sincere, and help us to find your saving love in this church. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Our help is in the name of the Lord. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia. Quia quem eruis deportare. Alleluia. Resurrexi sicut dixit.